Be a best of five match. First player to win three games. Games played to 11 points. Must win by two. It's Pesotska in red to start off with the serves. Love all. Perfect read of the top and side spin here. And Takahashi takes the first point with the first shot. Oh, warning on the service toss. Higher, please, was the warning. An adjustment quickly made. Takahashi with some very compact backhand strokes in this rally.
Cool.
Now this is what Pesotska is going to have to do and probably will continue to look for, opportunities to get in early. And right down the line, skee-balls that one up the edge. A bit of a flatter shot, that punching backhand. I think of that more as Pesotska's game. From a little bit behind the table, it's going to be tougher to make that confidently. Now, if you're just joining us, that high toss serve we see from Sean Xiaona, Yuan Jianan. Runa Takahashi pulling it out here, too. It gives the ball more speed coming into the racket, which means there's more potential to generate spin, faster serves. It's just tougher to control.
Six, three.
Good placement on this one. Takahashi right into that middle. She gets the turn out of her opponent. Just amazing defense on the side of Pesotska. It takes a good four or five shots before the middle can be found. Takahashi doesn't stop working for it, though. Uses the legs to get low and power through that.
Seven, five.
Good spin on the opening shot here. The receive from Pesotska. Interestingly enough, she didn't come in with the wrist really tucked back. Not the way you would have seen, say, few of the top women in the world, like Chun Meng, who I believe these two are fighting to play against tomorrow.
Left. 7-5.
Good counter from Takahashi, seven, using the spin. Not just using the spin coming in, but also using her own to spin it back and get that wrist action, as opposed to the flatter punch shot that we saw earlier on a few occasions.
Six, eight.
Pesotska gets that lead back. She's worked well in the service game from the middle of the table. Again, we don't see too many players doing backhand serves, but both out here. Something you would see from Darko Jorgic or Kara Kosovic, players that dominate in the backhand, or defenders.
9-7.
A lot of work for 1 point, but it sets up 3 game points for Ukraine's Margarita Pesotska here in the first. Again, not a flashy game, but a smart, consistent game. And that's all that it takes, stability, consistency, and really decisive play. Pesotska with game number one. Players back to the table for game number two. Bruna Takahashi in the black and blue, starting off with the serve.
Takahashi to serve. Long ball.
Just cleaning the dust off the rubber there, making sure that there's full traction for the spin game.
Long one.
Seems to get the grip for the spin there, but overlifting, maybe a misread of the spin from the other side. I was quite impressed watching Bruna Takahashi play in the last month or two. I felt like just the fire in her shots. She was quite dangerous, very explosive. Pesotska doesn't seem to be bothered by it yet.
Two love. Three love.
Fired up, as you can understand. First point on the scoreboard here, and after being down one game, Takahashi really needs to ignite some fire and find some answers.
At 1-3.
I just love how much thinking is going on in any moment. Watch the feet right now of Bruna Takahashi. Just constantly replanting as Pesotska moves her around.
Five, one.
Immediately after saying that, my impulse was to watch the feet of Pesotska as well, just to see how they'd be different. It feels like she's more clear in her place. That's Pesotska there. Watch her feet. Steps in a little bit for the touch. Confident, it was a short rally, but confident to open with the backhand. Man, no time for messing around nor getting into the rally. That was a rally finisher from Takahashi.
Three, five.
Interesting. Seemed like service fault there. Pesotska had been warned before about the height of her toss.
3-6.
That's impressive, though. I mean, mentally, to just accept it and go on. Smart. No arguing, no getting distracted in conversation.
6-4.
Beautiful combination, one down the middle and then wide on top of the bounce out in front. Takes this early, what a wide exit angle to the table here from Takahashi. It's a lot of footwork there, just hopping around, staying in position. A lot of blocking here, but very confident. One eye, Bruna Takahashi. Watch the coverage here in the blocking game. Vysotska not only keeps the racket high, but way out in front. And when her first forehand comes into play, it finishes the point. Heavy spin on the push. Toni Pezotska, one of the three top women and the only attacker of those three top women from Ukraine. Just goes to show you how much defense is a factor there. Thinking about that because of the backspin she can generate in her push game.
10-5.
2 points in a row, getting the shot back into the net. And it is 5 game points for Margarita Pezotska. But too many rockets and one that doesn't come back, courtesy of Bruna Takahashi. Well, now, Bruna Takahashi, right on top of the bounce, giving Pezotska a taste of her own medicine here. Saving another game point, 3 more to go for her opponent. But the streak continues, and at the third towel break, we don't talk about Bruna in terms of the chance of coming back to win this. It's a timeout now on Pezotska's side. That wasn't just an Encanto pun, but that she is the number 3 woman on the Ukrainian team currently by world ranking. Now, conveniently for a lot of players, there is a feeder event going on at the same time as this champions event. So many players from the same teams just short walk away across the hall. It's interesting with Jean-Rene Meunier in the corner. Tactically speaking, we saw this in the start for Takahashi, and we saw it in the start not only of this match for Takahashi, but also for Hugo Calderano in his match, which is get in and make that first attack count. Play your first attack to finish the point. It's a lot to recover from after that lunging, moving in forehand. Well played by Takahashi, but watch where she has to recover to. Full stroke forehand, and it comes right back into the middle. Just amazing how far ahead these players can think. Where is my opponent going to be jumping to recover? And where will her right elbow be in that moment? This is what they train for. Takahashi just turning from that backhand corner behind the table. Spinny backhand. 2 backhands to finish, but she got the forehand where she wanted it early as well. Ooh.
4-4.
Omiyage, a little souvenir for Pezotska to take home with her. We're potentially on to the next round.
Yeah. 5-4.
But the fight is very real right now, in the sense that both players are willing to take their chances. Vysotska is the more stable player, safe in quotes.
Five, six.
And it's tough. I mean, you're playing someone who's so consistent. Many players have fallen at the hands of Margarita Pesotska. She's quite an understated player.
7-5.
And a timeout on a towel break, huh? Second time we've seen that recently. So the Portuguese in the corner there.
7-5.
Jean-René Meunier with many languages in his arsenal. Rina Takahashi as well, actually. Many of these players incredibly well-traveled, playing overseas all the time. Ooh, and a tight serve here. Pesotska with a major sneaky serve. Stays low, comes underneath the Chiquita banana flick. Top edge of the racket here, Pesotska with the heavy spin to make the ball accelerate out off the bounce. See that full stroke backhand. Oh, and the angle finds the deep corner of the table. It is now 4 match points for Margarita Pesotska to move on to the round of 16. And covers the middle, a strong performance and a shutout from Ukraine's Margarita Pesotska.